Well, I think it's real ancient. Like a lot of things in our culture, I don't know that they're necessarily evolved. You know, a lot of things had been shown to our people, like how to make a canoe, how to make, you know, the medicines were shown to our people by the supernaturals, the totem poles and things were actually seen first in the supernatural world before they were brought onto our side. So I think that, you know, there's something that's passed down to us that is Haida art. And, you know, we inherit that right to it. And if you want to do something, I mean, everybody's entitled to do whatever they want, but if you want to do Haida art, it's pretty well set what it is, what it means. You know, because you're a Haida and you paint a few lines on a piece of board or something doesn't mean it's Haida art. It might be your own art, unless it's done properly.
Once I started understanding the dancing and the culture, it allowed my art to grow, because then it became ceremonial. When I did a headpiece, I made sure it fit so that I can use it for dancing. And I always used to get in an argument with one of the dealers that you didn't need to sing and dance. And I said, I didn't say you need to sing and dance. You have to understand it. Because everything that was made at one time was made at a purpose. It really allowed me to grow in the art, understanding what I was doing. Because when I'm doing ceremony, all that is theater. Like, to me, that's all this is theater. And all I'm doing is trying to portray something.